I opened the shop up in 97, but the main influence for me was probably Factory Records, the Hacienda. I don't think the shop would be here if it weren't for the Hacienda. I think it had that impact on everyone in the city. It was like the place to go to. It was our church back in the day. My name's Colin White, owner of Vinyl Revival in Manchester. When the Hacienda closed down, it was like a free-for-all. Everyone was just told to come and take what they want. I went down and there was just loads of memorabilia that I just thought, you know, well worth keeping hold of. So I've got a Factory Records original three-tier leather-bound checkbook that I've been getting Manchester bands to sign. Hopefully when it's full, I will auction it to raise money for cancer research. It's got a great history, Manchester, right back to the 60s. You know, we had a great scene then, which a lot of people forget. 70s, we had the punk scene with the Buzzcocks Joy Division. 80s, we had the Smiths, New Order. It's like every few years, something just comes along and you think, wow, another great band, you know, and there's no other city I know does it. I think Manchester produces so many bands is because the only things we've got is football and music. We haven't got a beach, we haven't got the sun all year round. Most people I grew up with, they've all been in bands, you know. You either get into football, you get into music, it's two things. And when I opened in 97, I realised there was no one sort of specialising in Manchester music. We'd already got a rich history of bands coming out of the city, and we knew it. We had tourists coming to the city to, you know, to visit places like the Salford Lads Club, the Hacienda. So I thought I'd tap into that market, sort of create a shop that people could come to, you know, and buy bands right back from the 60s, from the beat stuff, up to the punk stuff, and right through to modern day bands like Doves, Elbow, Blossoms.